Hi friends, I welcome you all to today's session with regard to finance related current affairs for upcoming RBI Grade B and SEBI Grade A examination. Now friends, the topic which we are going to discuss today, it pertains to enhanced governance norms for credit rating agencies. So friends, SEBI has recently come up with a circular dealing with enhanced governance norms for the credit rating agencies in India. So basically in this video, we are going to decode the concept of credit rating agencies and the key features of this recent circular of SEBI in the form of MCQs. Now friends, if you are a paid subscriber of our courses, you need not watch this video again, and you can find the entire discussion on this circular along with the basic concept and the MCQs also in your course itself. Now before proceeding forward, let me quickly tell you about the excellent results that we have achieved over the past few years. Now in 2017, in RBI Grade B, we had 27 final selections from our students, and in NABARD Grade A, we had 11 final selections from our students. And in 2018, we repeated the same success story, and in RBI Grade B, we had 70 plus final selections, and in NABARD Grade A, we had 26 final selections. Also, in 2018 SEBI Grade A examination, out of the total 84 selections, 41 of our students, they made it to the final list. And in the IBPS AFO examination, our students have got 100 plus interview calls. Now, if I talk about the different individual courses that we are providing, then they include RBI Grade B, SEBI Grade A, NABARD Grade A, RBI Assistant and IBPS AFO examinations. Now, apart from running the separate courses for all those individual examinations, we are also having some combo courses which you can avail. So we have a combo for RBI Grade B, NABARD Grade A and SEBI Grade A. We are also having a combo for RBI Grade B, NABARD Grade A, SEBI Grade A, RBI Grade B and NABARD Grade A and SEBI Grade A. So we have all the requisite combos that you can choose from, and you can choose the appropriate course as per your requirements. Let me also tell you about our new course, which is very important for all the banking exams. This is the QRE course. QRE, that is Quantitative Aptitude, Reasoning Ability and English. So all these aspects which are very important for all the banking exams, they are going to be covered in this particular course. So friends, let's start our discussion on the MCQs, which can be framed out of this particular topic. First question. Which of the following is incorrect about credit rating agencies? Options are, it is organization that gives rating to debtors or borrowers on the basis of their ability to pay back their principal loan and interest on time. It gives an idea of the probability of committing a default by them on debt and other credit related instruments. It gives ratings not only to the organizations but also to individual customers. None is incorrect. So friends, this question is primarily related to the basic concept of credit rating agencies. So friends, let's talk about the meaning of credit rating agencies. So friends, a credit rating agency is basically an organization which is going to give a rating to debtors or borrowers, which can be government or which can be companies, on the basis of their ability to pay back their principal loan and interest on time. So a credit rating agency is basically an organization. This organization is going to check whether a company which is borrowing money will be able to repay that money along with interest. And on this basis, it is going to assign a rating or assign a grade to it. It's very much similar to how you were assigned grades in school or college. So similarly, the companies are going to be assigned grade, whether it's going to be an A grade or B grade, depending on their credit worthiness. So basically, this credit rating, it gives an idea of the probability of default by the company on the debt or other credit related instruments being issued by it. Now, a very important fact to be remembered here is that the rating is given to the organizations. The companies and the instruments being issued by them, they are the primary domain of the credit rating agencies. Individual customers, they are not rated by these credit rating agencies. Now, when we talk about the individual customers, for them, separate credit score is computed. So, individual customers, they are primarily synced with this credit score only and not the credit rating. So, appropriate term for individuals is credit score and not credit rating. Now, this credit rating, it helps the investors or the customers to get an overall idea of the strength and stability of the company. So, if you are going to invest in that particular company, you can know the rating and you can see whether the company has the appropriate strength to repay or to pay back the money you are lending to this company. Now, examples of credit rating agencies in India include CRISIL, ICRA, CARE, SMERA, Fitch India, or ONICRA. They are some of the examples of the credit rating agencies in India. So friends, now we can easily answer this question that the credit rating agencies, it gives ratings to the organizations only and not to the individual customers, because these customers, they are given credit score. So clearly the answer to this question is going to be option number 3. Next question, credit rating agencies in India are regulated under. Options are SEBI Credit Rating Agencies Regulations 1993, SEBI Credit Rating Agencies Regulations 1999, SEBI Credit Rating Agencies Regulations 2003, or SEBI Credit Rating Agencies Regulations 2007. So friends, we are primarily being asked about the regulations which pertain to CRAs in India. Now let's talk about the SEBI regulations pertaining to credit rating agencies. So friends, credit rating agencies in India, they're regulated under the Securities and Exchange Board of India, Credit Rating Agencies, Regulations 1999. So regulations pertaining to credit rating agencies, they were issued by SEBI way back in 1999. So if any person wishes to commence any activity as a credit rating agency, so suppose if you wish to start a credit rating agency, then you would have to make an application to the board or the SEBI for getting a certificate of registration for this particular purpose. So SEBI is going to examine your application. It may even ask for some extra information or any clarification from you, and on the basis of that, it is going to process your application and it is going to grant you a certificate of registration for the purpose of carrying out the credit rating. Now, the certificate of registration which is going to be granted, this is going to be valid unless it is suspended or cancelled by the board. So, this is basically going to have a lifetime validity unless it is suspended or cancelled by the board. So, there are some grounds or conditions in which the certificate, it may be cancelled. So friends, now we can easily answer this question that the credit rating agencies in India, they are regulated under the Securities and Exchange Board of India Credit Rating Agencies Regulations 1999. So clearly option number 2 is our answer here. Next question, which of the following is correct about the norms pertaining to registration of credit rating agencies in India? Options are, any person proposing to commence any activity as a credit rating agency shall make an application to the board for the grant of certificate of registration for this purpose. Option 2, the certificate of registration granted shall be valid for a period of 5 years only. Both are correct or none is correct. So friends, from our discussion on the previous question itself, we have learned that the certificate of registration being granted to the credit rating agency is going to be valid unless it is suspended or cancelled by the board. So here option number 1 is only going to be the correct one and is going to be the answer here. Next question, which of the following is correct about credit rating committees vis-a-vis the rating process to be followed by credit rating agencies? Options are, every credit rating agency shall have professional rating committees comprising members who are adequately qualified and knowledgeable to assign a rating. All rating decisions, including the decisions regarding the changes in rating, shall be taken by the rating committee. Rating committee of a credit rating agency shall report to a chief ratings officer. All of the above are correct. So friends, every credit rating agency has to follow a proper rating process. The process of rating cannot be a haphazard process. It has to be systemized. A proper course of action has to be followed when you are rating any security. Now this becomes very important because this process only is going to ensure transparency and accountability for the rating agency. If it has followed the appropriate process, it can accordingly always quote that I followed my process, so I was correct in my rating. The company, it may default later on, but the credit rating agency has to take a proper procedure. Every credit rating agency shall have a professional rating committee, which would comprise members who are adequately qualified and knowledgeable to assign a rating. So within a rating agency, there is going to be a professional rating committee. So on the one side, there is a credit rating agency, and within this rating agency, there is going to be a rating committee. This rating committee is going to comprise of people who are going to have proper qualification, proper knowledge to assign the rating. So all the rating decisions, including the decisions with regard to changes in rating, have to be taken by this rating committee only. Now, an important point to be remembered here is that a credit rating agency shall not rate the securities issued by it. Suppose a credit rating agency itself issues some securities. Now, if it comments on the credit worthiness for these particular securities, it would basically be a conflict of interest, and this is prohibited. Also, it has been mentioned that rating definition as well as structure for a particular rating product shall not be changed by a credit rating agency without prior information to the board. So basically, if the rating agency is doing any changes, it has to give proper information to the SEBI board. Now let's talk about the enhanced governance norms, which have been primarily issued as a part of the recent circular being issued by SEBI. So the circular states that MD or CEO of a credit rating agency shall not be a member of the rating committee of the credit rating agency. So a person who is at the hem of the affairs of a rating agency should not be a member of the rating committee, because now again we want transparency, we want accountability, and we do not want any conflict of interest. We do not want that in order to make the company, to make the credit rating agency profitable, the person may give a positive rating to a company, but in reality, the company may not deserve that particular ranking. So that's why this provision has been made. Further, it states that rating committee of a credit rating agency shall report to a chief ratings officer. So there has to be a person who is going to be designated as chief ratings officer, and the rating committee is going to report to this particular officer. Further, 1/3 of the board of directors of the credit rating agency shall comprise of the independent directors. So they are the persons who do not have any financial interest in that particular company. So it says that if the board is chaired by a non-executive director, then 1/3 should be independent directors. But in case the board is chaired by an executive director, half of the board shall comprise of the independent director. So this primarily emphasizes that there has to be some minimum level of independent directors in the board in order to ensure that credit rating agency, it functions in an efficient manner, it functions in a transparent manner. Further, it states that the board of a credit rating agency shall constitute the following committees. These are rating subcommittee and nomination and remuneration committee. So these committees, they are now also required to be constituted by the board of credit rating agency. Again, the objective remains to enhance the governance to promote accountability and transparency. So friends, now we can easily answer this question that all of the given statements here are correct with regard to the credit rating committees in the context of credit rating agencies. Next question. As per the recently issued enhanced governance norms issued by SEBI, which of the following is incorrect? Options are: MD CEO of a credit rating agency shall not be a member of the rating committees of the credit rating agency. 1/3 of the board of the credit rating agency shall comprise of independent directors if the board is chaired by a non-executive director. The board of a credit rating agency shall constitute ratings subcommittee and nomination and remuneration committee. None is incorrect. So friends, based on our discussion in the previous question itself, we can easily answer this question that here all of the given statements, they are correct. So our answer here is going to be option number 4, none is incorrect. So guys, this was all about our discussion. If you are having any query, you can mail us at hello@edutap.co.in or you can reach us at 8146207241. You can call us or you can WhatsApp us. And I would also recommend that you visit our website www.edutap.co.in for regular updates and important content on the respective examinations. Thank you guys. I wish you happy learning and all the best from the entire team.